Welcome to worship. This is the first Sunday in Lent. You have received a letter from Pastor Tim indicating that he will be beginning a new call as an intentional interim pastor in our synod. We are, of course, saddened that he will be leaving our staff, but we say thank you to him for 23 years of faithful, powerful ministry at Lutheran Church of the Good Shepherd, for his deep spirit and genuine service. We say thank you and God bless you to Pastor Tim. Pastor Tim's final Sunday preaching will be on March 7th, and his official last day will be March 15th. Because of the COVID protocols, we will not be able to have a gathering or a meal in his honor, but we will publicly thank him during our worship service on March 14th, and we invite you all to please send him cards and letters of appreciation, giving your thanks for his ministry at Good Shepherd and how he has touched your life. Last Wednesday, we entered Lent on Ash Wednesday. Today, we continue our Lent journey, remembering that the depth of our Lent preparation determines the height of our Easter celebration. On Wednesdays, we'll be having a confirmation drive-throughs, and then at 7 o'clock to Wednesday evening, hold an evening prayer service coming online, along with Psalms of Lament and Hope, featuring watercolor paintings by Rosemary Guttormson in Holden Evening Prayer. We also will be offering a Thursday Bible study at 5:30 on the very psalm we studied on Wednesday evening. It's a Zoom Bible study. If you'd like to participate in that, please send me an email, and I will send you the Zoom invitation for the Thursday 5:30 Bible study. Thanks today to Marge Kangas, being our liturgist, for Katie Rich for the children's sermon, Linda Turpening for prelude and postlude and piano accompaniment, and Debbie Sanders as our choir director. And to our singers today, Patty Altonen, Bruce Johnson, Jill Kaiser, Ellen Ramsey, Judy Rogers, Tom Seidelman, and Amy Evanth for her video production. We begin with the order of confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbor as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your holy name, amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. The prayer of the day. Holy God, Heavenly Father, in the waters of the flood you saved the chosen, and in the wilderness of temptation you protected your Son from sin. Renew us in the gift of baptism. May your holy angels be with us, that the wicked foe may have no power over us, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. It is time for the children's sermon. And for today's children's sermon, Jasper and Betsy are here at church with me. I don't know if you'll see them in the video or not because they are just running around the sanctuary. They are so happy to be here. So if you see this video with Jasper and Betsy and your first thought is, I want to go to the sanctuary. I want to explore in there and run around like Jasper and Betsy. Well, guess what? You can. We're going to have another Sunday school open house on March 14th. We did this at Christmas, and it was great because kids could come to the sanctuary, hear the story, and then make a craft before they go home. So we're going to do that again. You can come to church on March 14th. This time, you'll hear the Easter story, and you'll make an Easter garden with the grass seed before you head home. So March 14th, your kids can come and explore the sanctuary and run around like Jasper and Betsy are doing today. I also want to let you know that today is the first Sunday in the season of Lent. So behind me here, I've got a paper chain. Every day between now and Easter is a link on that paper chain. And you can see we are counting down the days until Easter. And so every purple chain is a day of the week. The yellow chains are Sunday mornings. We are counting down and getting ready for Easter. That is what Lent is all about. And if you want to learn more about Lent, we do have Sunday school to-go bags that are all about Lent. And so you can learn more about it, stop by church, pick up your to-go bag, and take one home. All right, everybody, let's close in prayer. You can repeat after me. Dear God, Easter is coming.
Easter is coming.
We are so excited. Help us get ready.
Help us get ready.
And celebrate Lent.
And celebrate Lent.
Amen. Well, thank you so much, everybody. Have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Our gospel reading for the first Sunday in Lent is from Mark chapter 1, verses 9 through 15. In those days, Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. Just as he was coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens torn apart and the Spirit descending like a dove on him. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." And the Spirit immediately drove him out into the wilderness. He was in the wilderness 40 days, tempted by Satan, and he was with the wild beasts, and the angels waited on him. Now, after John was arrested, Jesus came to Galilee, proclaiming the good news of God and saying, "The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe in the good news," the gospel of our Lord. Mark tells the story of the beginning of Jesus' ministry as the Christ. In this beginning chapter, three scenes of three places, the Jordan River, the wilderness, and Galilee, and three actions, his baptism, his temptation, his proclamation of the kingdom. These three scenes describe Jesus' identity, his power, and his calling. And for all those in Mark's community, they describe their identity as his disciples, the power of word and spirit, and their calling to proclaim the kingdom of God. And for us as disciples today, these three scenes give the shape of our calling as ministers. It begins with his baptism. Baptized means to be dipped or identified. Not just water, but water plus God's word brings the Spirit's presence. It says that the heavens were torn or ripped open, and then something very powerful happens. Through the ripped heaven comes the Spirit and the voice of God. The word of God coming through that voice, God's word alive, God speaking. Those words describing Jesus, "You are my son," using the language of Psalm 110. The beloved, using the language of Genesis 22, where Abraham took his son, his only son, Isaac, whom he loved, and offered him to God. "With you I am well pleased," the opening line of the first servant song from Isaiah chapter 42. And so the voice of God, this word that comes to Jesus at his baptism, describes him as son, his identity, beloved, his relationship, and servant, his calling that will ultimately lead to his death and resurrection. This voice from heaven describes all that follows in the Gospel of Mark regarding Jesus, his identity, his relationship, and his calling. It doesn't end there. In our baptism, we are dipped, identified through water and the word, identified with Jesus. We are named children of God, our identity. Beloved, our relationship with God. Called as servants, our calling as his disciples. Not once at our baptism, but every day, living out this identity and this calling through the power of God's word, carried by the Spirit through our baptism. Thanks be to God.
To see your life unfold. I was there when you were born a child.
Immediately after his baptism, the Holy Spirit drives Jesus out into the wilderness. For 40 days, he's tempted by Satan about who he is. Driven by the Holy Spirit is the very word of being cast out. The Holy Spirit drives Jesus from his baptism to the wilderness. The temptation regards his identity as the Son. The temptations of Jesus by the devil in the wilderness, according to Matthew and Luke, start with this phrase, "If you are the Son of God, do this or that or the other thing." Jesus faces true demonic power. He is called Beelzebul. And he says, his enemies say he casts out demons by Beelzebul, the prince of the demons. And even his number one disciple, Peter, after Jesus says that he must suffer and be rejected and die and rise, Peter says, "No, that'll never happen to you." And Jesus says to Peter, "Get behind me, Satan." Satan was using Peter to get Jesus to avoid the cross, his identity and his power. The issues of the temptation are lived out in the story then in the Gospel of Mark. For Jesus on the road to Jerusalem to die and to rise. And then for every disciple, if any want to be my followers, Jesus says, let them deny themselves, take up their cross, and follow me. The identity and power for Jesus is also the identity and power of his disciples. The wilderness, yes, is a place of temptation. It's also a place of prayer and power and direction and purpose. The temptation that comes to us defines the edges of our calling, of loving unconditionally, and of living the life of power for which we are created. After his baptism and his temptation, Jesus then goes to Galilee and begins to proclaim the gospel of God, saying, "The time is fulfilled, the kingdom of God has come near, repent and believe in the good news." Galilee becomes the place of the proclamation of the good news of the gospel. Baptism and temptation lead to proclamation. That word that carries the spirit and identity and power for Jesus is now proclaimed in the words of the kingdom, proclaimed by Jesus, by his disciples, and by us as his disciples. The content of the proclamation is the kingdom of God, loving God with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength, loving our neighbor as ourselves, hearing God's word and doing it, and then in this gospel text, specifically by repenting, turning back to God, and believing by the actions that we live, believing in Jesus as the Christ. Our life as disciples begins with a transformation in our hearts through our baptism, our temptation, and our proclamation. From word and spirit, the very power of God lived out daily in the shape of a cross. Repentance and believing. Thanks be to God.
Your only Son.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The prayers of intercession. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. In Jesus, your realm has come near to us in every place and time. Give your church throughout the world a spirit of humility and repentance. Teach us to trust always in the good news of your salvation. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You have made a covenant of mercy with every living creature. Protect all the earth's creatures from destruction. Empower the work of biologists, conservationists, and science educators. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. All your paths are steadfast love and faithfulness. Direct the words and actions of leaders in our community and throughout the world, that they may maintain justice for the lowly. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Even in the wilderness, you are with us. Walk alongside migrants and refugees crossing dangerous lands. Tend to those whose lives feel desolate. Give healing and strength to all who suffer. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In the covenant of baptism, you claim us as beloved children. Nurture us in our baptismal identity and teach us to live within it for the sake of others. Strengthen this congregation's ministries of care and concern. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. In baptism, you join us to the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. We praise you for all those who have died trusting in your faithfulness. Bring us with them to the fullness of your reign. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always, and also with you.
We live out our baptismal calling as children of God by offering ourselves, our time, and our possessions to God. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we gather in feeding the world with your love, through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Pray with me the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hold you. Holy Angels.